if you're having a discussion on whatever the case may be on slavery, then you can talk about everything dealing with slavery, the good, the bad, the ugly, the
There's no good to slavery, though.
Well, then whatever the case may be.
So that exchange has gone viral after a Republican state lawmaker in Louisiana argued that public schools and colleges should teach the, and you heard him say it, the good part of slavery. The good part. The state rep was pushing an education bill he proposed that would bar divisive concepts such as racism and sexism from classrooms. I want to bring in Louisiana State Representative Stephanie Hilferty. Representative, you were the one who spoke out loud. Yours was the voice, I believe, on that tape saying, wait a second, there's no good side to slavery. Now, I understand that Representative Ray Garofalo, who was the other guy, he walked back his statement. But still, what was going through your head when he was arguing there, we have to talk about the good from slavery?
Yeah, I think thank you for having me on. The chairman had an unfortunate lapse in judgment in using that turn of phrase, the good, the bad, and the ugly, which, you know, colloquialism, and then in reference to slavery. If you listen a few seconds after that, he does realize what he said and say that I think something to the effect of, oh my gosh, I shouldn't have used that phrase in reference to slavery, and I apologize. And my reaction was very instinctual to say there's no good in slavery. And I think that is something that 99% of my colleagues would say, Republican and Democrat, when faced with that statement. So I don't think I was special in saying it. It was just my first instinct when he made that comment.
Right. Maybe it was a slip of the tongue. Or maybe it's a feature of the legislation he's proposing, which I think directly calls for the prohibition of the discussion of divisive concepts as part of a larger course of academic instruction. Look, don't you need to talk about slavery? Don't you need to talk about how bad slavery is? The Holocaust. You don't need to both sides the Holocaust here. You could talk about how bad that is. So isn't that a flaw with the legislation he's promoting?
Yeah, and actually, let me point out, I did mention, I said slavery and the Holocaust, those are two issues that we would, we have agreed that there are not two sides to teach to those instances. And I did point that out. Would actually, when you read the bill, when I read it, was confusing to understand the mechanics of it. It was vague in its wording. And the question I was asking is, the bill actually says it does not prohibit the teaching of divisive concepts as it relates to a larger course of academic instruction. And my question to him was, how do you see this playing out in the classroom? That's when he mentioned the good and the bad and the ugly of slavery. And I said, there's no good to slavery. That's how that interaction came about.
I mean, shouldn't, to an extent, discussion of slavery and the Holocaust, shouldn't it be painful? Shouldn't it cause introspection that causes us to reflect on where we've been?
I would agree with that. And I think that's what's being taught in our schools. So as part of the larger discussion, we spent 5 hours on this bill. And during that time, that was part of the discussion was these are being taught in our schools. I'm a product of, I went to school in Louisiana, and those were certainly taught. Both the Holocaust and slavery, among many other subjects. And it is painful to understand what people went through in Louisiana during slavery and certainly what happened during the Holocaust. So without a doubt. But that was, and I think that is, I'm positive that's being taught in our schools. And what I suggested to the chairman was we are actually going through an overview of all of our social studies curriculum this year in the Board of Elementary and Secondary Education, which functions as our statewide school board, that this is the time we understand what's being taught in our schools and have that community discussion about it. That is the perfect opportunity for that. But, you know, I think what's unfortunate to me is people on Tuesday looked at their computer, looked at their phone, looked at their screen and saw that a Louisiana lawmaker was talking about the good in slavery. And as a Louisiana resident, that's very sad to me. We have a beautiful culture here. I live in New Orleans. New Orleans is a town that openly welcomes guests, especially as we come out of the pandemic. We certainly want people from all over the country and all over the world to look at us as a destination for lively culture and for good times, as the case may be. And so it saddens me that is what people are seeing. Mm-hmm. I think it was a very unfortunate lapse of judgment, as I said, in using that phrase, the good, the bad, and the ugly, in conjunction with slavery.
Representative Hilferty.
But furthermore,
okay. Go ahead.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead, I'll let you finish, sorry.
What I was gonna say is, I mean, in the House Education Committee, I'm a mother to two young children, 2 and 4 years old. When I think about the work of the House Education Committee and the Senate Education Committee and overall of state government, we need to be focusing on our literacy rates. We just received mm-hmm. a report that we have kindergarten, first, second, and third graders falling behind in literacy. And we know that if you are behind in literacy in third grade, that is not a good progress point and could lead to severe issues further on in schooling. We need to look at the expansion of early education and how that coincides with our right. workforce development. I mean, those are the issues I think we need to be discussing and working through in the House Education Committee.
It's a great point, and you do wonder why certain things are priorities to some people. Representative Hilferty, we really appreciate you being with us. Thanks so much for joining us.